Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome back to an episode of Seek and Destroy. And today we're taking a look at this awesome Amazon exclusive 5-pack Spider-Man Beyond Amazing Funko Pop box set. Yeah, so you can see my reflection in there. This is really cool. You actually get a couple of really neat, unique Spider-Mans in here. You get Spider-Man Armor Mark II. You get the Spider-Man Armor Mark I. That's cool. That's from Web of Spider-Man number 100. You also get the Prince of Arachne. And then you get the real reason why I bought this box set. You get the Hornet and you get Prodigy. These are two Spider-Man characters that are costumes of his. There was a time in the 90s where they did a story where Spider-Man was wanted and Norman Osborn put a bounty on his head for like $1 million. So everybody wanted Spider-Man. They wanted to unmask him. They turned the citizens against Spider-Man and they framed him for a murder essentially. So what he did to try to prove his innocence is he went out and created or found one, but then helped create three or four costumes to kind of disguise himself as in a story called Identity Crisis. And I actually have some of those issues right here because one of the costumes, my favorite one, which is in this box set, you get the Hornet. The Hornet suit itself was created by Hobie Brown, who is the Prowler in the Spider-Man universe, one of my favorite characters in the Spider-Man universe. And so you get the Prowler here. He's created this costume for Spider-Man, and together they kind of worked on it. And now Spider-Man is out there as the Hornet trying to prove his innocence as Spider-Man so that he can go back to being Spider-Man. But he also created some other identities. He created the Prodigy, who is the other toy in this set, obviously. So we got Prodigy, there's Hornet there, and Prodigy. But then in the books, you had Ricochet. So this is Slingers number one, but he had Prodigy there, Hornet, Dusk, and Ricochet. And I also have, all four versions of issue one here. There's Hornet there, here is Dusk, and then here is Prodigy. Yes, I'm a big fan of these characters. So what happened is Spider-Man created these costumes, and he tried to prove his innocence. And once he did prove his innocence, he kind of gave the costumes away, just said, I'm not going to use them at all. And a character in the Marvel Universe, an old character actually, the Black Marvel, he took those costumes and he gave them to four teenagers and turned them into this group, the Slingers. So yeah, look at that. Really cool cover there. All these characters living in Spider-Man's shadow. And the characters in the Slingers I love tremendously. I actually wrote a screenplay where I wanted to make a movie about the Slingers. I wrote it in a couple different ways. I actually wrote a television version. So I wrote like a pilot for a TV show. And then I also wrote a full screenplay. I really wanted so badly, even when I was working at Sony, I really wanted so badly to make the Slingers movie. That was like a dream of mine. And I actually have like pretty much half of a journal completely dedicated to all the stories of me trying to meet people and pitch it and try to get an agent and a, you know, a literary agent and everything and someone to represent me and trying to get it like to Amy Pascal. And, you know, it was like all these things I was trying to do without like pushing any lines or being unprofessional and stuff. I was trying to go through all the proper channels and I never did it, but it was always a dream of mine to do something with the Slingers. I'm a big fan of the characters. So I actually have the entire run of their book. There's issue 3 and issue 4. I just kind of bagged and boarded them back to back, issue 5 and issue 6. And this is it's a really fun series. Actually, I've always liked it. I think I did an episode on it a while ago, like a live stream. So yeah, we've talked about them to ad nauseum, but I have the whole entire run of the book, 9 and 10 and 11 and 12. That's where the last stand at Devil's Gate. Really cool and really cool moments in it. Some of the characters that you don't like, you know, you end up liking a lot by the end, and they just did a lot of cool things with the characters. And they actually did some crappy things with these characters, especially Hornet. I think he got it the worst. So I'm going to open this box set now and get the characters out. And I honestly don't, you know, the other three are cool. We're going to show them off right here. They look cool. They're nice and all, but I really bought this set for these two on the end. And it comes with this cool base that you can put them all on, but I'm pretty much just gonna wait until they make Dusk and Ricochet, and then I'm gonna put all four of them on this base with the classic Spider-Man in the middle to kind of represent you know, that era of Spider-Man comics in the late 90s. So yeah, Hornet and Prodigy here. So, and like I said, I think Dusk is coming out, and then Ricochet is the only one they haven't announced, but I hope they make him too. Because I actually have a book here with Ricochet that stars him. But before we get into that, I want to talk about the crappy things they've done with Hornet. Like in Wolverine, Enemy of the State, they kill him off screen. And actually, Eddie, the guy who is the Hornet, the teenager that is given the costume, he has cerebral palsy, and when he's wearing the suit, it helps him straighten out his arm and use it. And so he kind of becomes addicted to the suit because it makes him feel quote unquote normal. And so there was a great story they were doing there, and I was hoping for more of that one day. And unfortunately, Mark Millar just randomly killed him when Wolverine got brainwashed by the Hand, and Logan killed Eddie in the story Enemy of the State, which is just a bummer, because I was like, well, there goes any future stories of him. But then I thought, oh, maybe it's not canon. Maybe they'll say it wasn't Hornet or someone else in his costume. But then this series came out, which was called The Loners. And in this series, we got to follow Ricochet after leaving the Slingers and after Eddie's death. And he confirms in this book that Eddie is gone. So I have all 6 issues of The Loners. They did all these cool homage covers to like Weird Science and all these great, you know, 80s movies and stuff. So that kind of confirmed it. And then it even more confirmed it a couple years ago when the all-new Wolverine comic was out, and you had actually Hornet's sister show up in this book as the new Hornet, and she fights Spider-Gwen and Wolverine Laura, X-23. And then there's also the Zero issue I have behind it there. So where it introduces the team and Cassie, and it brings, you know, shows her death, who is Dusk, and it shows her death, and then she comes back to life and rejoins the team. So she got to come back, but they killed her in the first issue, actually the Zero issue. But then again, just this last year, the Hornet character showed up in Spider-Man and Scarlet Spider's comic. So that was cool to see the Slingers kind of come back, because someone new shows up as Hornet, and the Slingers are like, even though Prodigy's not around, Ricochet and Dusk are like, hey, we got to see if this is our friend Eddie. Turns out it wasn't. It was a Wolverine villain that was like disguised as Hornet. And also Prodigy, who's still been missing in action ever since, I believe, the Hero Initiative. So after Civil War and all the heroes had to sign up and work for the government, Prodigy, in a big twist, because he's kind of a character who blindly follows orders. That's how he was in the original Slingers book. And he decided to go against the Registration Act, and they beat the living crap out of him and arrested him. And no one's really seen him or heard much of him since. So I hope they bring that character back at some point, too. I think he's popped up or mentioned a couple times, but nothing solid with him. But after Scarlet Spider's book that Peter David wrote, we got the Slingers back a little bit. Like this past year, like I was just about to say, we had this awesome Planet of the Symbiotes King in Black single issue. And this one by Jeffrey Thorne brought the Hornet back, but this time gave it to its original creator. So the suit is now worn by Hobie Brown. Again, one of my favorite Spider-Man characters. And he is no longer the Prowler, because ever since they brought Miles Morales into the Marvel Universe, the main Marvel Universe, his uncle Aaron has been the Prowler. So Hobie's kind of been without an identity, and he went around dressed as Spider-Man for a while, helping Peter Parker out. He was a clone for a while, which was weird, and then they got rid of that, and they retconned that. So it's cool that Jeffrey Thorne brought him back, and we talked about this on the channel where we discussed this issue and how excited I was that Hornet was back, and he's bringing back the Slingers, and hopefully he's out there right now looking for Prodigy, because they need him to complete the team. So yeah, I'm a big fan of these characters, and I'm so happy that they actually, for 60th anniversary of Spider-Man, they made these Funko Pops as Spider-Man variant costumes. So these are just really cool. And this is, like I said, it's available on Amazon. I think $50 or $60 for the whole set, the box set. But I really, as cool as the other ones are, I'm going to probably find good homes for them with someone else, because I really just bought the set for these. I put on my Amazon card. I was like, screw it. I was like, I just paid it off recently. Why not? Let's buy these. So now I'm going to be on the lookout for Dusk. And it is not Cassie's version of Dusk. It's Spider-Man's version of Dusk. So these are all the Spider-Man Peter Parker variant versions. But they do look, you know, very similar to the Slinger comics. But just when the Dusk toy comes out, he's going to be a male body instead of a female body. So he'll be Peter Parker Dusk instead of Cassie Dusk. So hopefully they do a Cassie version at some point, like a variant. I would love that. And hopefully they put Ricochet out, so we can have the whole team. So let me know what you think. If you're a fan of these characters, do you collect Funko Pops? If you do, do you have any favorites? And out of the Beyond Amazing Spider-Man 60th anniversary stuff, there's manga Spider-Man, six-arm Spider-Man, Spider-Man 2099. There's all these different versions of Spider-Man. Which one is your favorite? Which one are you trying to track down? Let me know down below. And as always, we'll keep talking down there. So thanks so much. Thanks for letting me talk about the Slingers. I love these characters so much. So it's really cool to talk about them with you guys. And hopefully Marvel, like I just did it in a recent episode with Supernaturals, like Marvel, please reprint the Slinger Saga. I will help you, you know, map the book. I know exactly where the first time, you know, in Tales of, like, the Web Spinner Tales or whatever, when the costume of Dusk first showed up on the first Dusk, and then it went to the second Dusk in Peter Parker Spider-Man, and then Spider-Man got it, and then he brought it back during the Identity Crisis storyline. Like, I would help you map. I'm sure someone over there can do it without my help, but I would, again, I just always wanted to be a part of something with the Slingers. And if I can help map an omnibus, I'm more than happy to do it. So just let me know. I'm not that you have my number or anything, but I'm here. If you ever need me, I'm happy to work on something with the Slingers and help get an omnibus or something out there that features the 12 issues, the zero issue, all the different versions of issue one, putting in the loners in there, putting in some Avengers Academy with Prodigy, anything we can squeeze in there to kind of get people caught up to date, because I have a feeling we're going to see more Slinger stuff in the future. And maybe that's just wishful thinking. Who knows? Time will tell, right? But thank you so much for watching the show. As always, like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff. And I'll see you all in the future. Peace.